December 29th, 2020. To the marine park, yay! As soon as we arrived, we checked in and then made our way down the docks. Here we are walking down the dock. As you can see on the sides, there's not so much water because the tide isn't high yet, but on our way back it was just like filled, and we saw a lot of sea urchins and other smaller fishes, but we were waiting for our smaller boat to take us to the larger boat. Here we are on our way. Everyone was kind of freaking out because the boat was moving from side to side, but we made it there safely. Whoa, 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 pause the tape. Story time. While we were taking the boat ride, they ended up telling us some really cool legends, which I'm pretty sure they made up on the spot, but it was really cool as we looked at the islands to imagine. Here we finally made it to an area which we were spotting dolphins. Everyone was yelling flipper as we tried to spot the dolphins, and we did. We saw a few dolphins, as you can see over there. They even had a child with them, and we also had a lot of fun yelling in the middle of the ocean. Oh, and I also met a classmate. Talk about awkward. But anyway, the dolphins were super cute. The footage you're about to see next is from Fathy's Instagram story. If you guys do not know who Fathy is, he's the one who organized the entire trip for us and the whole package. I'll leave all his details in the description below. And basically, he went on another trip. And remember, whenever you're going for snorkeling or to the marine park, it's all about luck of how you see the dolphins. So this trip, this crew or this team that he went with was lucky enough to see these many dolphins. I left the footage just so you can get an idea. As you saw in the video, children were selling these beautiful shells and other sea artifacts. We did help by supporting them by buying them, as this is their way of surviving. You can do this or bring for them other essentials. It's up to you. Thank you. pause the video for a second. Here's where I'm going to explain to you what's happening. So basically, we entered the bridge, the Kikoni Bridge, which was funded by the Wasini Women Group, and they use the money which they find in this project, which they earn in this project, to help the children in Wasini Island. So here are the payments you need to pay when before you enter the bridge, keeping in mind that it all goes to the better of the Wasini children. This is a cool project they worked on, which was recycling plastic bottles around the island. Go green! So here we are at the famous bridge that I was talking about. So when you first enter, there's a few shacks which you can see the different kinds of views. Don't worry, I will show pictures of the views that I took. I'm so sorry that the road was kind of bumpy because as you can see, there's so many coral rocks on the floor. But there's the bridge and you can go all around the mangrove forest, as I call it, and still end up back in the same spot. There's so many different directions, but it's just like a small little journey. And you still end up going back to the ending up in the same area. So, yeah. As you can see around this area, it's surrounded by coral rocks, some baby seaweeds, as I call them, that we ended up eating at lunch, as you guys saw in the previous pictures. So, here we are. Trust me, it may look scary, but this thing was so stable. I can't stress the fact that it was that stable enough. So my phone ended up running out of charge, so I ended up taking pictures instead. But I love the project. I love the rustic vibe of it. Those are the baby seaweeds. And the fact that it managed to hold all of us onto the area. To Wasini Island, as I call it, the Forgotten Island, because literally they have no power. They use solar panels. It's mostly salty water, so they have to wait for rainwater, or they have to go to the mainland to get resources such as food and vegetables and stuff like that. The mainland is where we came from, Shimoni, which is the marine park, and also secondary school. They have to end up moving to the mainland because the only kind of school they have there is primary school. And other than that, they have to use their own creativity, their own ways of making a living or surviving in Wasini Island. And yeah, honestly, I found that super amazing. And if you guys do end up choosing to go for the snorkeling trip, make sure you can carry any kind of supplies to go send to the families there. You can carry sweets. My friend who I met there as well ended up carrying some biscuits and stuff. We didn't actually know that we could, but we did end up supporting the kids there by buying their amazing shells. Let me go get one. Okay, I got them. Okay, so here's one. Let's see. How did they put them in there? Oh my. Okay, so basically when we bought it, oh, it closes. Okay, basically when we bought it, it did not close. It was like this, and then the shell was on the inside, and yeah, basically like this guy over here. It was like this, and then this shell was on the inside. But then for some reason, my dad decided he liked them separately, so he removed the shell from the inside, and that's how it ended up being. I found these shells super, super beautiful because, I mean, the kids ended up being entrepreneurs from such a young age. So we supported them by buying their shells and stuff. And you can do that too if you go to Wasini Island. You can support them by buying their shells. There's also some other beautiful stuff that they made. I will roll the clip for you and not talk too much. But yeah, you can support them by doing that. And yeah, I highly recommend everyone to try and go to Wasini Island. It is beautiful, the snorkeling is worth, the food is delicious, and everyone there was super sweet and super nice. And speaking of creativity, you will see an amazing kind of project that the Wasini Women Association did, and you can all go by supporting them. Let's go check it out.
Bye. Basically, we're returning right now and going back to Mombasa from the marine wildlife place. I'm tired, exhausted. But so far, I think it went well, better than I had expected in the morning when I was being rushed. I didn't record that, and I had a hard time recording some other things. But right now, we're going to go board the ferry. It should be like half an hour to reach the ferry. I'm not sure. I'll let you guys know. But yeah, so far, this is how far we've been.
Clara, umechoka?
Totally, yeah. Kabisa, kabisa.
Don't forget to share this video with your friends to let them know. Remember, during this entire trip, we did follow all COVID laws, and yep, the rest of the information is on there. That's all from me. This is Tasha, logging out.